Caduman, Canada.
Hello everyone, I'm Hardman Canada, a boy with a mustache. I can speak with my telepathic power. I will show you my Puyo Puyo game collection in a chronological order. My movie is separated into many parts because it's very long. I link each part in my video description section. That way, everyone will be happy, even those of you who won't watch my video in one shot. Now I have to get changed. Your characters in my house? What are you doing here? Why are you here? What? Where did you come from? What are you doing?
Don't be rude to our guest. Me, the Colo Colo, your guardian angel. I invited them without your permission. They came here to see your movie. Let the movie begin.
Puyo Puyo 1 is a puzzle game created by Compil. It was released in 1991 on MSX, a home computer system that was available in the 80s. Basically, in Puyo Puyo, we assemble 4 blocks of the same color to make it disappear. Puyo Puyo on MSX had 2 game modes. One where you play to survive as long as possible, and the other is mission mode, where you complete a task with a predetermined block placement. Compil wanted to put Puyo Puyo on arcade, and they team up with Sega because of the experience they have on the arcade market. To make Puyo Puyo different than other puzzle games like Tetris and Kulum, they made 3 changes. 1. Including more characters. 2. Creating a story mode. And 3. Making Puyo Puyo based on a competitive gameplay to make it more fun and addictive. Because of these changes, Puyo Puyo became popular in Japanese arcade. And later, his popularity at some point was similar to Street Fighter in arcade. And Sega made Puyo Puyo for the Sega Genesis in 1992, making it the first Puyo Puyo game to be released on a home console. What I like about Puyo Puyo 1 is that every opponent possesses a different strategy, and you beat them by sending them black blocks under dungeon with the combination of color blocks that you create. I also like the dropping speed of Puyo Puyo. I like the dropping speed of your Puyos that increase as you advance in the game. By the way, character on Puyo Puyo was based on the role-playing game series called Mado Monotagari. And Alulu in Japanese, is the main character of the series. Dr. Robotnik Min Bean Machine for the Sega Genesis is the American and European version of Puyo Puyo made in 1993. Sega and Compil used characters from the Sonic cartoon to make this game. some music are similar. Like I was born in Japan, and when I moved to Canada and I tried this game, it looked so familiar to me for some reason. After a few weeks, I realized it was Puyo Puyo that I saw at my friend's place. That was a long time ago. It's so nostalgic. It was similar to Puyo Puyo 1. I remember when you reach the stage 9 for the first time, you fight against the boss. And the boss traumatized me in my childhood for 3 reasons. When you reach stage 9, the music changes and it will surprise you. 2. The boss says something like this to you. Forget the opponent you face so far because their intelligence are inferior to me. And number 3. The speed of the game increases so much that you can't see anything while a crazy maniac like him is beating you in a few seconds. By the way, for those of you who watch my video for the first time and don't believe that I'm Japanese because of my appearance, so here's some proof that I'm Japanese. Picture is worth 1,000 words. I even appeared on a Japanese newspaper. By the way, elementary school in Japanese is much harder. You learn timetables in grade 1. I'm getting off topic. Back to Puyo Puyo games. Here's Puyo Puyo 1 for the Sega Game Gear. What? I've been Rickrolled. I need to sleep to calm down.
Sasquatch! The bad dream you had is a sign that your game of kill your instinct is in danger. The Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch might come. Me and Dokuro have a bad feeling about this. Be careful!
Okay, Sasquatch. Thanks for the warning. I will be careful. Hey, Goro!
Hey, how do we say? Excuse me, but are you a Canadian in Spanish?
Sumimasen, anata wa Canada jin desu ka?
Isn't that Japanese?
No. It's in Spanish.
If you lie to me, someone will die.
Goro. You always fall for my trap, at every time.
The Game Gear version of Puyo Puyo 1 came out in 1993. An extra mode was added, the puzzle mode. It's an enhanced version of mission mode of Puyo Puyo on MSX. Some missions are almost impossible. Here's an interesting fact. Puyo Puyo on Game Gear only came out in Japan, but when the game detects that the game is running on a Canadian console, the game will translate itself into English. I don't know if it will change if you play this game on other countries. Puyo's Kid is the translation of Puyo Puyo. A bad translation. I make video in French and English, and the person who did this is not trustworthy to translate my work. Goro is the type of person to fall to this trap. The Game Gear version of Robotnik Min Bean came out in 1993. Just like the Game Gear version of Puyo Puyo, we added the puzzle mode with 20 impossible missions to do. With the positive review of puzzle mode in the Game Gear version of Robotnik Min Bean and the Game Gear version of Puyo Puyo, we made a game based on it. Nazo Puyo 2 came out in 1993. Just like the puzzle mode, we give you an impossible task to do with a predetermined Puyo placement. There is over 100 missions. There is impossible mission like eliminating all the red Puyo in 3 turns while stealing meat from a lion by punching a crocodile and coming back in one piece. It's only the first mission. I have a figurine set of Puyo Puyo. Here's Drago Center, my favorite character, and she challenged other girls to beauty contest, and she later became one of ours best friends. She breathed fire like Dalsim, but she have no chance to beat me in a beauty contest. Arlie, the main character, she's a mage and a tough warrior. Harpy, an angel with a beautiful voice. Ironically, she don't know how to sing. Satan, the final boss of Puyo Puyo. He is evil. Sutetodala, a dancing fish. I put this on the counter of my home. When a guest arrive, I show them who's boss. Puyo Puyo 2 came out in 1994 for the Sega Genesis. You must be Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch. What's your problem? No! Not Killer Instinct! Somebody! Help me! Arlie! Witch! He stole Killer Instinct technique! Be very careful! Witch! No! You attack my guest. It's unacceptable. My attack have no effect. You fight like someone who don't have a mustache.
Stop! Come fight against me! Dokorokoro! Hardman Canada's guardian angel!
Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch! You are stronger than Cat Mario! Let's attack together! Cat Mario killed Dokorokoro and me, but Goro resurrected us with the Dragon Balls! Since that day we got way stronger because we trained a lot! Dokorokoro, it's time to use our super transformation!
Super Dokorokoro. Advantage. He's invincible to almost any attack. His ability have a boost of 1000%. He can use electric attack. He uses his aura to protect himself against magic attack and some long range attack. Disadvantage. He's vulnerable to magic attack and some long range attack. He can maintain his super form to 5 to 40 minutes depending on how much energy he consumes. His aura consumes a lot of energy, and copper is his greatest weakness. It makes him dizzy and drains his superpower. Copper radiation hurts him a lot and it's deadly for him. Kobu Sakura. Sakura. In Kobu Sakura form, Sakura summons Kobu, the spiritual robot that will act as her armor. In this form, Sakura's spiritual power is raised by 800%. The armor protects Sakura from every attack. Sakura has two elemental types just like in Pokemon, Ghost type
an iron type. Now her disadvantage. Sakura feels the same pain as her armor during strong attacks. And just like Dokolokolo, copper is her weakness.
All you got? Ultra Electric Dokolokolo Wave! His fur.
Puyo Puyo 2 came out in 1994 for the arcade and the Sega Genesis. It's a huge improvement over the first game. Number 1, we can counter-attack garbage Puyo with our own chain. That way we can survive when a maniac throws us 6 chains or more. Number 2, we can use a new technique called double rotation that lets us move Puyo when we are stuck between 2 rows of Puyos. Number 3, we can edit rules now. For example, we can play with hard Puyo as a garbage Puyo where we have to erase Puyo twice instead of once to free yourself, or the point Puyo where your offensive power will get stronger when you counter-attack. With these changes, the rule of Puyo Puyo 2 became the standard rule of the Puyo Puyo. We even use the Puyo Puyo 2 rule in most Puyo Puyo tournaments even to this day. In 1997, we used the Puyo Puyo 2 rules in Puyo Puyo tournament. And even in 2012, we used the Puyo Puyo 2 rules in Puyo Puyo tournament. Even in co-op mode, we used the Puyo Puyo 2 rules. Do you see? Puyo Puyo 2 had a big impact for the Puyo Puyo series.
Arigato! Witch ga ite yokatta to omotta no hajimete da yo!
It's very ironic. My 4 favorite game series are Sonic, Mega Man, Street Fighter, and Puyo Puyo. And the second game of each of these series had a commercial success so high
that a lot of people consider it like the most popular or the best game of the series, and we use elements from that game to make it a standard for the rest of the series. For example, Sonic 2 with its spin dash, Mega Man 2 with its 8 boss selection, Street Fighter 2 with the 6 button controller, and of course Puyo Puyo 2 with the counter attack and double rotation. Shizu became one of my favorite characters because I thought he was the final boss, because he appeared by surprise once you defeat everyone in story mode. Drago Center is my favorite character as always, and she became one of the strongest characters. In Puyo Puyo 1, she was the weakest. Rulu is also one of my favorite characters for no reason, because of my mustache. I have a sweater of Puyo Puyo 2, a perfect match for my mustache. Nazo Puyo Puyo, Aruru Noru. It's another Puyo game based on mission. Impossible mission. This time you control Owl and talk to characters from Puyo Puyo universe that will give you ingredients for Owl to prepare food like Kale rice, a Japanese curry. If you can finish the impossible missions. Thank you.
If Al wants to cook, she should hire a cooker with a mustache because they are the best. In 1995, Naso Puyo Puyo Lulu Nolu came out for the Super Nintendo. It's the same principle as Naso Puyo Puyo Alulu Nolu for the Sega Game Gear. But Lulu in Japanese, is the main character this time. During this era, Sega only published Puyo Puyo game for its own console and in arcade. But to publish Puyo Puyo game on non-Sega console, Compile team up with Banpresto. Imagine this, having Uncharted on Xbox 360, Halo on PlayStation 3, and Ape Escape on the Wii. It will be weird to publish game for your competition. In this game, you control Al or Rulu. But the missions are harder and more impossible. Al's impossible missions are possible for the most part. But with Rulu, you play hard mode and her missions are even more impossible. They are killer. If you want to die, play as Rulu. For example, in this mission, you have to do 5 chains with only blue blocks without touching the wall after stealing food from a dangerous dog. I'm just a baldy young man with a mustache for crying out loud.
I will achieve killer instinct, but it's too late. Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch drained most of his life energy. He doesn't have much time.
Hey, killer instinct. Say combo breaker, your favorite sentence. Please wake up. You can't die! You are strong! Please wake up! No! No, no, no! You cannot die! Why?
I was almost was almost as handsome as you, Harlan Kendra. My father, Kazuma War, brought me killer instinct for the Super Nintendo. Because of this game, I was finally able to find real friends that I kept over the years, including Dokolokolo and Gobo. Killer Instinct have the power to unleash our instinct to find good friends that will accept you for who you are. But some bad people destroy this game to steal the combo breaker technique. Once me and Dokolokolo became a guardian angel, I found a student called Taiga who was training to be a samurai. Our first meeting was New York City in North America. But we didn't know that North America was the territory of Big Foot. A Big Foot sensed my game of killer instinct, unfortunately.
No, the pleasure is all mine. My name is Lieutenant Shinjiro Taiga.
Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch hired men to steal money from the bank and kill the instinct while Taiga was alone.
Make sure you keep it safe.
Okay.
One more thing. No matter what enemies you come across, just believe in yourself.
He retrieved the money, but Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch ran away with Killer Instinct, and the game was found dead a few hours later. Have courage, my friend. You must continue the video. We will have our revenge.
Yes, you are right. I will have my revenge. Puyo Puyo 2 still on Sega Saturn is the enhanced version of Puyo Puyo 2 for the Sega Genesis. It came out in 1995 with more game mode, and we added cutscenes with voiceovers. One mode you should try is Rally mode. In this mode you control R and you fight against every character of the game. Every 624,341 characters of the game. And they will play at their best. Be careful. Mando Monotagari is an RPG game that came out in 1996 for the Sega Genesis. In this game, you control Arlie when she was a cute little adorable little baby that was defenseless that killed bad guys.
Fire!
you control her inside a dungeon. You control Harley in a first-person mode with no gun. I dare you to play Halo with no gun. The combat system is strange. You have no numeric information and you press button while holding the A button to attack. You also have to push button to jump and to block to evade enemy attacks. The battle system happens in real time, so you must think quickly. If you blink, you die. Like there isn't any numeric information, you have to guess the character's health with their body language. I have one problem with this game. There isn't many characters with a mustache. By the way, Madam Monotagali came out in 1990 for the MSX, and the enhanced version came out for the Sega Genesis and for the PC in 1996. I like the manual of Puyo Puyo game because it's colorful and it possesses small comic books. Here's a Sega poster showing the most popular game on the Sega Genesis. It came with some copies of Puyo Puyo game brought on the Sega Genesis. You can see Puyo Puyo 2 for 6,800 yen. It's an equivalent of 68 Canadian dollars. You can see Samurai Showdown for $88, Sonic and Knuckles for $78, Rise Star and Yu Yu Hakusho for $88. Video games were more expensive back then, but at least there were no DLC, with the exception of Sonic and Knuckles being the extension of Sonic 3 with the lock-on technology. Currently, new PS3 game cost $60 in Canada, and that's without the DLC. If we buy game with the DLC, the game will cost for over $100 Canadian dollars.
Thank you.
Puyo Puyo Sound came out in arcade in 1996 and later ported for the Sega Saturn in 1997. It's the third game of the main storyline. The combat system is based with suns that appear the more you counterattack. If you erase your Puyos along with your suns, your offensive power will get stronger. The same thing goes with your counterattack. With this, a weaker opponent can beat a stronger opponent. With this, a weaker Puyo player can beat a stronger Puyo player unless the difference in skills is very high. The game possesses three main characters. The three characters are based on their popularity. Drago Center, Arlie Nadha, and Shadow Regular. Drago Center is the easy mode. Arlie is the normal mode. And Shizu is the expert mode for players who want to die. With Shizu, you will have the chance to fight against Carbuncle. Carbuncle is the small yellow creature you saw in Robotic Min Bean. Carbuncle is the secret final boss of this game. He is very hard. If you give him the chance, he will build Puyo formation to execute a combo of 9 to 20 chains, followed by an all clear. An all clear is a bonus you have once you clear all the Puyo on your field. Puyo Puyo Sun is the last Puyo Puyo game where the drop speed of the game will get very fast. If you like playing fast puzzle game, play Puyo Puyo Sun. Puyo Puyo Sun have 8 difficulty level. Beginner, very easy, normal, hard, very hard, expert, and mania. If you choose mania, you will wake up inside a hospital. I'm only warning you once. Puyo Puyo Sound for the Sega Saturn can play online, but you need the Netlink edition of Puyo Puyo Sound. Today, the Netlink edition of Puyo Puyo Sound is very rare. This is the official strategy guide of Puyo Puyo Sound. Here's a list of some of the things available for this guide. We explain what's Puyo Puyo. We give you tricks to practice to make you big chains. It includes stickers of Arl, Drago Center, and Shizu. We give you game art during the game conception. We teach you how to play Puyo Puyo. It have mini Puyo Puyo comic books, which is very funny. It contains detailed information about character, like their weight and height. For example, Rulu's weight is 56 kilograms. Ha! I'm lighter than her. Ha ha! It contains animation of each character doing their second chain to the seventh chain, as well as their victory pose and their defeated pose. It also contains game secrets like how to unlock characters for the multiplayer mode. It also possesses the history of Puyo Puyo and Mado Monotagali from 1998 to 1997. It have music note to play some Puyo Puyo music on piano. It also have commercials and merchandise like Puyo Puyo cake and Puyo Puyo candies. By now they are expired, so don't eat them. Every person with a mustache should have this book if they respect themselves. This is a comic book of Puyo Puyo. It contains many small stories. They are quite funny. If you play all the Puyo Puyo game, you will understand all the jokes. It's a good book. It's a good object for collectors. This Puyo Puyo comic book is a shonen comic book. It's a comic book that is more based on action and comedy. Usually, boys prefer this kind of comic book. And a shoujo comic book is a comic book that is more based on romance and drama. Usually, girls prefer this kind of comic book. So, this Puyo Puyo book is a shonen comic book. I have a letter from Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch. He is mad at me because Dokolokolo and Sakwa War defeated him and almost ruined his plan to absorb the life energy of Killer Instinct. To teach me a lesson, he is challenging me to a Puyo Puyo match. If I lose, my mustache will be shaved. I accept your challenge. After all, I have to avenge Killer Instinct's death.
Be careful! Paranormal experts believe that Bigfoot can teleport by traveling between dimensions. Listen to this very well.
On every continent, there are legends of Bigfoot. And evidence that might prove the story is true.
We can't.
Myths describing human-like monsters who travel between dimensions.
They have the ability to appear and disappear at will.
It's one of the reasons why Bigfoot hunters have a hard time capturing a Bigfoot. He even survived my finished move as Super Dokolokolo by going into another dimension. We have a bad feeling about this. Good luck. We wish you good luck.
Get ready to lose. What happened? We traveled into a different dimension.
Hey!
Yeti Sasquatch have the advantage in this dimension. I'm going to lose. Please, someone, anyone, help me. Center, you saved me. We are back into our dimension. Thank you very much. You saved my mustache. Drago Center did this because of what you did to Arlie, her best friend. Power of my mustache. Waku Waku Puyo Puyo Dungeon is an action RPG game where you travel across many dungeons and fight against many enemies. We have a choice between Rulu, Arl and Shizu. In my opinion, it's not the best game of its type. I didn't have a very good impression when I first played this game. I don't recommend this game unless you are a fan of Puyo Puyo. Here's an interesting information regarding the world of Puyo Puyo. The creature made of jello comes in many colors. People call them Puyo Puyo because they scream by saying Puyo. Puyo, and they vanish when they touch three other members of the same species. They are weird creatures. Mado Murotagali for the Sega Saturn is the one of the best RPG ever made. The intro of this game starts very well because you will understand what's happening and you will want to continue playing this game. You control a young man named Lagnus the Brave who went inside a dungeon to kill Yogus the Demon to protect his planet. Because Yogus the Demon controls other creatures by turning them berserk and summon demons, he conquers Lagnus the Brave planet. By himself, Lagnus killed Yogus' servants before having an epic battle against him. So that's right, you fight against the final boss in the first chapter.
But before Lagnus the Brave delivered the final blow, Yogus cursed But Yogus escaped and ran away to another planet to recover his strength. And with his magic, he cursed Lagnus the Brave and turned him into a little child to make sure that he is too weak to kill him, just in case he come back to finish his job. After a few days, Arl's planet started to have real events like good creature turning berserk and the appearance of more demons. Arl will team up with many Puyo Puyo characters to solve this mystery, but she don't know that Yogus is responsible for this, and she don't know the existence of Lagnus the Brave, who seemed to be the only one who know how to kill him. But Lagnus the Brave is currently a child too weak to kill him. That's a big problem. In this game, it's a turn-based traditional RPG, and the battle system is very simple. It's one of the best looking 2D games of the Sega Saturn, and use the full potential of the powerful 2D processor of the Sega Saturn. Beautiful and colorful animation for its era. I recommend this game to everyone who loves RPG. The story is interesting, and I swear it's one of the best RPG for the Sega Saturn. This is a mouse part of Rulu, a Puyo Puyo character. I use it with my laptop even in school. I made a video about it a few months ago. Do you remember the song Puyo Puyo Sparta? Yeah. Some of you remember it. Look at her clothes. Do you see something? I think she's from Sparta. Puyo Puyo 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 Sparta. Look at her. Look at her clothes. Look at her. Look at her clothes. Look at her clothes. Look at her clothes. Look at her clothes. Look at. Yo Puyo Sparta. 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 Puyo Puyo 4 came out in 1999 for the Sega Dreamcast. It's one of the best Puyo Puyo games in my opinion.
By the way, I must warn you, my copy of Puyo Puyo 4 is a defective one because it's one of the third generation Dreamcast games. Some third generation Dreamcast games had a manufacturing problem, for example Sonic Adventure and Puyo Puyo 4, where the game was defective. Defective Dreamcast game or the first generation, sometimes the game will not start up even once you put the game inside the Dreamcast, and there might be some sound problem and some graphical problems. So I'm warning you. And by the way, the cameraman was mad at me because he was jealous that I had Puyo Puyo 4. No, it's for me.
Thank you.
The new element in this game are the special attack that's unique to each character. Once you have enough energy, your character can use a special attack. For example, using a shield, eliminating Nushin's Puyo or Puyo of the same color, summoning a dragon, shaving a boy's mustache, turning your field upside down to your advantage, raising your attack power, and raising your counter-attack power, and many more. A Puyo-Puyo battle in Puyo-Puyo 4 could last like 30 minutes because of the special attack. But one element in the game was disappointing. The drop speed of Puyo are slow, even during the final level. With a few exceptions, the low drop speed element will be kept in future Puyo-Puyo game, which is disappointing. It's too bad because I like playing with fast speed because it's more challenging. In Puyo-Puyo 1, Puyo-Puyo 2, Puyo-Puyo Sun and Robotic Min Bean, as you progress in the game, the Puyo-Puyo drop speed will increase. Compared to other Puyo-Puyo games, the story in the story mode is more serious. The artificial intelligence of this game is higher than the previous game. And that's an element that will be kept in future Puyo-Puyo games. It's recommended to play this game with an arcade stick. This puzzle game is not human. You need an arcade stick to play this game. Puyo-Puyo Da is a rhythm game for the Sega Dreamcast that came out in 1999. In this game, we control characters from the Puyo-Puyo universe and we copy moves made by your opponent to send them nuisance Puyos. The person who receives nuisance Puyos at the end of the music battle will lose. This music battle system is called the Elena system. The main character of this game is called Elena and she came from a small game called Broadway Legend Elena that came inside the Disc Station magazine in 1994. The Disc Station magazine is comparable to Nintendo Power, but it's about Puyo Puyo game and other compil game. The game came on floppy disk or CD. The floppy disk is the old USB. In this game you have to copy your opponent's movement just like in Puyo Puyo Da because Elena wanted to be the best dancer in the world. In the internet, we say that this game is not compatible with a dance pad. It's false. Don't believe everything you see in the internet. I tested the game and it's compatible with a Dreamcast Konami dance pad. You just need to change your control in the option for it to be compatible with it. If you want to save your money, use a PlayStation 2 dance pad and plug it inside the Dreamcast with a Dreamcast PlayStation 2 port adapter. I made a video about it 2 years ago. In this game, we just discover each character's favorite music style. For example, Shizo listens to salsa, like Ozone.
Maya hi, Maya ho, Maya ha, Maya ha ha.
Rulu listens to rock music, like Linkin Park.
I've become so numb, I can see you there. Become so numb of my mustache.
Elena listens to pop music like Michael Jackson and Pussycat Dolls.
Are you okay? Are you okay? I'm okay, baby. Are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay, baby? Don't you wish your boyfriend was hot like me? Don't you wish your boyfriend had a mustache like me.
Don't ya? Don't ya?
Ali listened to rap music like Bahaman and Bad Boys made by Shine.
Who let the dog back in? Who let the dog back in?
Avancada, stop this instant. If you don't know how to sing, imagine if you were an American Idol, the judge of the American Idol would say bad things to you. Stop this.
Ouch. Dokolokolo, that hurt. What kind of guardian angel are you? You should be like Sakura Wo. Sakura Wo protects a boy with a mustache and his name is Tubo and she's very nice with him. But you, Dokolokolo, why are you tough on me?
I do it to make you stronger. Every time I finish you, you become stronger little by little. All kinds of bad guys come after you when you make your videos. For example, the Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch.
I was surprised to learn about each character's favorite music style, especially Arlie. Arlie listened to rap music. Rap music! Arlie listened to rap music. She's better than I thought. That's why she's the main character. Don't mess with Arlie. Puyo Puyo 1, Puyo Puyo 2, Puyo Puyo Some, and Puyo Puyo 4 are considered the four classic Puyo Puyo games. Between 1991 and 2000, Compile and Sega teamed up to make the main Puyo Puyo game, and it often released first on Sega consoles. Since the arcade debut of Puyo Puyo in 1991, these two companies kept a good relationship. The year 2000 is the end of the classic era of Puyo Puyo. Since 2001, Sega became the only responsible for the Puyo Puyo series. Eating ice cream with the classic Puyo Puyo game will raise the good taste of the ice cream because of my mustache. Around the year 2000, Compile had financial troubles and went bankrupt. After this sad event, Sega became 100% responsible for the Puyo Puyo series. In 2001, Puyo Pop came out for the Game Boy Advance. English version of this game exists. In story mode, there are 6 worlds, and each world comes with different rules, like playing with hard Puyo or playing with improved counter-attack. The basic rule is the same one as Puyo Puyo 2. Tiki will explain you each rules in the beginning of each world. Character have the same voice as Puyo Puyo-san, and the music is based of some older Puyo Puyo game, like this cutscene music is based of Nazo Puyo Puyo 2 for the Sega Game Gear. I wish Sega made more Puyo Puyo game like this. And you will see why when I will show you the next game. We can unlock character picture. What I don't like about this game is the slow drop speed of Puyo Puyo. Since Puyo Puyo 4, this element will stay. I have a Puyo Puyo keychain. Like you can see, it's Drago Center, my favorite Puyo Puyo character. With this, I show everyone who's boss. I have an unfair advantage because of my mustache. But I cannot show you the actual keychain because I lost my keychain when it fell down in the middle of the street without me noticing. I also lost my Aston Miku keychain the same day. It was made with a high quality metal that was expensive by itself. It was an item that came with the special edition of Project Diva S for PS Vita. Bad day happens sometimes. If you see me carrying the Drago Center keychain later in my video, it's because it was clip that I filmed before the incident. Puyo Puyo Fever came out in 2004 for the Nintendo GameCube. The game was in production in 2003. It's the first modern era Puyo Puyo game. This game had a lot of changes. First, Sega removed all the old characters except for Arl and Carbuncle to replace them by new ones. The new main character is Amity. I was disappointed by that. It's like in Street Fighter 3 when Capcom removed all the old characters to replace them by new ones, with the exception of Ryu and Ken. Alex was the main character in Street Fighter 3. It's similar to what happened with Puyo Puyo Fever and Street Fighter 3. We also changed the graphic style into a cardboard box graphic style. Personally, I prefer the classic style of graphic, like the one we see in Puyo Puyo Sun and Puyo Puyo 4. The new element in this game is the fever mode. Once you fill up the meter, you change into fever mode. In this mode, you create big combos by placing Puyo in the right place on a pre-arranged Puyo placement. We replace the Puyo Puyo 4 special attack system for the fever mode. This way, the battle will not last 30 minutes. To tell you my honest opinion, I prefer the battle system of Puyo Puyo 4 because I like the long battle and there is a bigger diversity of special attack that kept the game interesting. The GameCube version had a 3D effect during the fever mode. If I win a match with fever mode, I am not satisfied with my victory because I didn't win using my own ability. Even if the Puyo drop speed is slow, it's still a very fun game. This game is also available in English because of my mustache.
No way! You're looking too? I
Sega Superstar came out for the PlayStation 2 in 2004. It's a game filled with many mini-games and it uses motion control. You will need a PlayStation 2 camera called iToy. Motion control game existed before the Nintendo Wii and the Kinect of Microsoft Xbox 360. Motion control video game even existed in the 90s. For example, the Sega Activator for the Sega Genesis. It's a machine that you install in the shape of a ring that comes with a backpack that lets you play Sega Genesis game with motion control. Sega Superstar possessed mini game based on Sega franchises like Sonic, Night into Dream, Virtua Fighter, Space Channel 5, and many more. Let's not forget Puyo Puyo. By the way, it's preferable to play this game on a PlayStation 2 instead of a PlayStation 3 because of the camera compatibility problem. Only the first generation PlayStation 3 can play PlayStation 2 games. It's very important to know. Sonic Mega Collection. It's a collection game of Sonic games. It includes the Genesis version of Robotnik Min Bean as well as the Game Gear version with the puzzle mode of Nazu Puyo game. For younger gamers who don't have a Sega Genesis or a Sega Game Gear, it's your chance to play two Puyo Puyo games. This game is very accessible for younger gamers. It's on PlayStation 2. What I like about Robotnik Min Bean is that the Puyo drop speed gets faster as you advance in story mode. Here's another coincidence between two of my favorite series. Sega made collection game for Sonic for the PlayStation in the PlayStation 2 era, and Capcom made collection game for Mega Man in the PlayStation 2 era. For example, Sonic Mega Collection Plus and Sonic Gem Collection and Mega Man Anniversary Collection and Mega Man X Collection. Is it a coincidence or a destiny? I found the Nintendo DS version of Puyo Puyo Fever in the middle of nowhere, and it just happened that I had a camera and I was filming for no reason. It came out in 2005. In this version, you can play up to 8 players and you can use the touch screen to control your game. The thing I forgot to mention is that each character comes with their own drop set of Puyo Puyo. This element will remain in future Puyo Puyo games. In the classic era, each character only had 2 Puyo Puyo falling, but in this game, you can have different drop sets like the L Puyo, the Big Puyo, and the DNA Puyo. Each character will play differently. By the way, guess who she is. She's Arlie. I didn't recognize her the first time because of the cardboard style graphic. I miss the classic style graphic. By the way, Carbuncle is a secret boss of the game, just like in Puyo Puyo Sun. In Robotnik Min Bean, he was known as Has-Been. He's insanely hard. Get a load of this. He's a crazy maniac. To beat him, build chain as quickly as possible to block him, or else he will destroy you.
Did you do your homework about the Bigfoot? It's important to be well informed about your enemies.
Hey, if you didn't do your homework, someone will die.
Sakwawo, Gowo, don't worry. I'm well informed about Bigfoot. And I went to the biggest library of my city after my first fight against the Bigfoot Yeti Sasquatch. I'll make you a resume of what I learned.
Here's what I learned during my research. During history, there have been many stories about mysterious animals like the Minotaur, the Chupacabra, the Griffin, and the Loch Ness Monster. Ogopogo. We classify them as legends because there is no physical evidence about their existence. But there are two exceptions, and there is evidence that might prove their existence. One, the giant squid that can grow longer than 20 meters, and two, the Bigfoot. We believe that the Bigfoot are the descendants of Gigantopithecus, a 3-meter tall monkey that lived 300,000 years ago. Most of the Bigfoot in the planet live in North America, and that includes Mexico, United States, and Canada. There are four known species of Bigfoot. 1. The Yeti. It's a white-colored Bigfoot that we call the Abominable Snowman, who live in the cold places, like in north of Canada, like the Yukon Territory, Nunavut, and the north of Quebec. And they also live in Central Asia, the Himalaya Mountains. 2. The Yowie. It's a brown and dark brown colored Bigfoot who lives in the wood. The shape of their heads are triangle. 3. The skunk ape. The skunk ape are the Bigfoot of the color brown and black that live in dirty places, like inside the swamps, and they are known for their bad smell. They smell very bad. They live in Florida. 4. The Sasquatch. The Sasquatch are the most popular Bigfoot species, and they are the largest Bigfoot population in the North America. They are everywhere, in Mexico, in Texas, and even in Saskatchewan. The name of this territory is suspicious. Saskatchewan. The Sasquatch have a short neck. Unlike humans who can look left and right without turning their body, a Sasquatch must turn their body to look left and right because their neck is very, very short. For example, this video shows a walking Bigfoot. It was filmed in 1967. This Bigfoot is a Sasquatch because it's black and turns his body to look sideways. Paranormal experts think a Bigfoot can teleport by changing dimensions.
Good, you did your homework, but you forgot to mention that the Bigfoot have superhuman strength and the skunk ape look like an orangutan. Remember this, me, Goo, and Dokolokolo, we are stronger than you, Harald Bankandra. But Bigfoot Yeti Sasquatch is stronger than all three of us combined. To defeat someone stronger than you, you must use strategy. That's how me and Dokolokolo defeated Bigfoot Yeti Sasquatch when he attacked you earlier.
Thank you for your advice, Sakura Wo, but you talk way too much.
This is a Puyo Puyo pin. Nothing more to be said.
Pew Pew 15 anniversary. Street Fighter the movie. A game based on a movie based on a game. Get out of my sight. I can't believe this.
Puyo Puyo 15 anniversary came out for the PSP in 2006 to celebrate the 15th anniversary of the series. No one could have guessed that. No one. This game came only in this game only came out in Asia because Puyo Puyo isn't very popular outside of Asia. In my opinion, between 2001 and 2005, when Sega made Puyo Puyo game outside of Japan, they should have made more commercial about the relation about robotic Min Bean and Puyo Puyo to raise its popularity outside of Japan. For example, when I met new people that don't know what's Puyo Puyo, I talk about robotic Min Bean and now they know what I'm talking about. Sega missed an opportunity to raise the popularity of Puyo Puyo outside of Japan. But at least they tried their best between 2001 and 2005. Right now, I think they give up. This game possessed the same graphic style as Puyo Puyo Fever, something I'm not a big fan of. This game contained many game modes similar to a fighting game, like Street Fighter. There is an arcade mode where you choose your character to play the story, just like in Street Fighter. There is a survival mode where you fight against an infinite amount of opponents until you die like a man or a woman, just like in Street Fighter. There is a versus mode, just like in Street Fighter. And there is a tutorial mode, just like in Street Fighter. Puyo Puyo 15th anniversary possess more than 10 modes to celebrate the 15th anniversary of the series. 1.
the Puyo Puyo 1 mode with the rule of Puyo Puyo 1. 2. The Puyo Puyo 2 mode of the rule of Puyo Puyo 2. 3. The Puyo Puyo Fever mode of the rule of Puyo Puyo Fever. 4. The Big Puyo mode where you play with Big Puyo with reduced space. 5. The Bomb Puyo mode where you have to throw bomb to your opponent. 6. Infinite Fever mode where you play the Fever mode non-stop. 7. The Digging Puyo mode where the first one to reach the treasure win. 8. The Spinning Puyo mode where the field will turn at each interval. 9. Ice Puyo mode where you freeze your opponent. 10. The Mission Puyo mode where you must do an impossible mission. 11. Dark Puyo mode where you don't see anything. 12. Aqua Puyo mode where you play underwater. In this mode you must use a different strategy to create change because of the unbalanced water physics. Look at this PSP. It's the best PSP ever made. This is not a PSP. It's a Puyo-SP. I made a video about this a long time ago because of my mustache. By the way, Puyo Puyo 15th anniversary possesses my favorite music in the history of Puyo Puyo. It's called Final of Puyo Puyo. This music was available in Robotnik Mean Bean, in Puyo Puyo 1, and in Puyo Puyo 15th anniversary. Let's take this time to compare the best music in Puyo Puyo ever made. Superstar Tennis, what? Street Fighter the movie? What are you doing here? Get out of my sight. I will close my eyes and I will count up to three. And you should disappear. 1, 2, 3. What? You're still here? I'm going to close my eyes. I'm going to count to three. 1, 2, 3. By the name of love and justice. We are still there? No. That's your final warning. 1, 2, 3. Good. Sega Superstar Tennis. Street Fighter the movie. Leave Sega Superstar Tennis alone. Man, you're so annoying. Ah.
Sega Superstar Tennis isn't the only sport game that assembles Sega characters. There is also Sega Splash Golf that came out for PC for Windows XP in 2007. It's a golf game where Sega characters will appear for no reason. Characters from Fantasy Zone, Space Channel 5, Sonic, Sakura War, and of course, Puyo Puyo. By the way, you know what Master Chief says to Sonic in the phone? He says, "Hello." And Sonic tells him how to win an extra life in Sonic game. It's by collecting 100 golden Hello object.
Sega Splash Golf.
Sega Superstar Tennis came out in 2008. It's a tennis game made with Sega characters and make reference to other Sega games like House of the Dead, Space Harrier, Fantasy Zone, and Puyo Puyo. If you grew up with Sega consoles like me, you will be familiar with all of these characters and game reference. I wanted to show you the Puyo Puyo section of this game. It's my favorite mini game. A squirrel stole my Puyo Puyo game by thinking it was food. He thought Puyo Puyos were candies. I have a problem with squirrels. Not only I have nightmares about them, they steal my games. I retrieved my game when they went out. Puyo Puyo 7 came out in 2009 for the PSP. Now, to go home, I have to cross the river and go through the dangerous forest filled with dangerous wild animals. A Bigfoot might attack me. The new main character is Andolingo. And my favorite Puyo Puyo character is back, Drago Center. Between 2003 and 2009, she didn't appear in any Puyo Puyo games. Unfortunately, Puyo Puyo 7 used the graphic style of Puyo Puyo Fever, the cardboard box graphic style. Drago Center have a cardboard graphic style. She was prettier in the classic graphic style. Drago Center liked to challenge other people to beauty contest, but she doesn't stand a chance against me because of my mustache. It's too bad because this game possesses a limited number of classic characters that I find more interesting. The new special attack is the transformation mode, and you choose between mini or mega. In mini mode, your character will transform into a cute little adorable gentle baby. The power of your attack stay the same because it's based on the number of chain you create once because it's based on the number of chain you create. You can create up to 420,000 chains. It's similar to Fever mode. The other mode is called Mega. In this mode, your attack, your character transforms into an ugly, disgusting adult who has a problem with my mustache. In this mode, you have a big Puyo, but your attack are weak in the beginning. It will get continuously stronger because you will keep the power of the last independent chain you made to stock up the total power. If you play the game, you will understand what I mean. The new element in this game is that you can drop your Puyo
at the maximum speed by pressing up. It's very logical. Compared to other Puyo Puyo games, I didn't like this game that much. It doesn't have the charm of other Puyo Puyo games, especially the classic one, and have the feeling that the quality of this game is inferior and the characters are unbalanced. And then, Lagnus the Brave, who can transform into a child or an adult, isn't in this game. This game is perfect for him. He made his appearance in Puyo Puyo Sun. Like I said before, since Puyo Puyo 4, the Puyo Puyo drop speed stays slow. Here's a music CD of Puyo Puyo 7. It comes with stickers. The music of this CD contains vocal music of Puyo Puyo 7 and not in-game music of Puyo Puyo 7. We can see a small movie if we put it inside a computer. There's another important information I should share with you. There are seven classes of monsters. S being the strongest and F being the weakest. The class F monsters are fairies and umbrella monsters. The class E monsters are the chupacabras and the gray men that we also call the gray aliens. We believe they are aliens. A normal human have a strength comparable to class E monsters. For class D monsters, we have monsters like weak ghosts, mermaids, and zombies, and human with great athletic abilities, or human with spiritual powers, or human with supernatural powers, their strength is comparable to class D monsters. Humans like martial artists, wrestlers, a fortune teller, and magicians. Now for the class C monsters, we have monsters like the griffin, the minotaur, the giant squid, and the liger. Class B monsters are witches and Yuki Onna, also known as Snow Woman. Goro of Mortal Kombat is a class B monster. For the class A monsters, they are very strong ones. We have Cyclops, we have strong ghosts. Good strong ghosts are called angels and bad strong ghosts are called demons. And we also have dragons. Dragons are very strong. Dokolokolo and Sakura Wars have a strength comparable to A class monsters. Now for the S class monsters, they are extremely powerful. We have vampires, we have werewolf, we have foxes with many tails, and we have a Bigfoot. A Bigfoot is a S-class monster. I give you this information to, for that you will realize how strong Bigfoot are. They are very strong. Me, Holman Canada, like I'm a human, my strength is comparable to Class D monsters.
Captive bred super cat. Not a lion or a tiger, but a liger. At 900 pounds, but the scale of their predatory tools is unmatched, even in nature. Ligers share the same ancestral hardware with other big cats.
There they are. I have to say, the medical personnel at S4 are less than first rate. They tend to be selected for their willingness to keep secrets rather than their...
This is quite interesting to watch.
Oh, it's over that little hill, and it's coming at him.
Well, the crap...
Caillou. He was eating apples here, he was eating apples there. Something scared it. It had its back up, its tail between its legs, the hairs were sticking up on its back. The very following picture we got was of the creature.
It does look like the creature is larger.
That thing's way bigger than you. I don't even know if a padded suit could account for that.
Unless the thing was dramatically closer to the camera, I don't see how this could be anything else but a Sasquatch. It is so large. This thing might be 7, 7.5 or something like that.
And if it's 7 or 7.5 even, that still puts it in the range of a female. And who would be carrying baby?
A female, exactly.
I disassembled my PlayStation 3 to paint it and decorate it with Puyo Puyo characters. Here's my three favorite Puyo Puyo characters: Rulu, Shezo, and Drago Center. I made a video about this a few years ago. I have a habit to customize my video game consoles. This is not a PS3, it's a Puyo 3.
How do we say I love pineapple in French?
Me gusta la piña.
If you lie to me, someone will die.
Puyo Puyo 7 for the Nintendo DS came out in 2009, before the PSP version. Here's the advantage of the DS. The advantage, it can play online and it can play up to 8 players. Now, the disadvantage, there's an inferior artificial intelligence, inferior sound quality, characters don't talk in cutscene, and the graphic and animation are inferior. I made a video about this in details a few years ago. I have the DS version just to try and play online on Puyo Puyo games. Personally, the online system for the Nintendo is inferior to PlayStation Network and Xbox Live Arcade. I remember, me and Docolocolo, we had an argument about which system is the better, PlayStation 3 or Xbox 360. Xbox! PlayStation! Xbox! PlayStation! Xbox! Ah! Ah! With Nintendo, we must use a friend code to play online. I can't remember my social insurance number and they expect me to use a friend code? But since I changed my modem, I can't play online with my Nintendo DS anymore. And I still didn't find a solution to this problem. By the way, in this game, there is a stage of Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch. It's scary. But here's another coincidence between my favorite game series. My favorite character is in Puyo Puyo is Drago Center, and she spits fire with her mouth. My favorite Street Fighter character is Dalsim, and he also spits fire with his mouth. Coincidence or destiny? I think I like people who spit fire because Canadians live in the cold. It will be good to spit fire with our mouth to melt all the snow in my area. Sonic's Ultimate Genesis Collection is a collection of over 40 Sega Genesis games. It includes the Sega Genesis version of Robotnik Mean Bean with enhanced HD graphic. It came out for the PlayStation 3. This game cost me 46 Canadian dollars. Genesis game costed like $70 each in the 90s. Be grateful that you didn't pay $70 for each game for a total of over $2,800 Canadian dollars. By the way, they made a serious mistake. We put an image of Sonic 3 and we said it's Sonic 2. Really? Epic fail. Capcom is also victim of fatal errors. In the manual of the Mega Man X8, Capcom made a mistake between the French and English version. Let me show you. Do you see that? By mistake, they copy-paste layers description on palette's description. You see that? They made a mistake between the translation. Can you believe that? Sega and Capcom have many things in common. One of them is making fatal errors in game boxes and manuals. Yakuza 4 is a beat-em-up game in an open world where you explore the city to accomplish missions. Sega made this game in 2010. Between mission, you have free time to do whatever you want. You can play mini game inside the arcade. You can see Sonic and Virtua Fighter. I was hoping to see a Puyo Puyo mini game, but I didn't find anything. I decided to show this game anyway because of my mustache. Puyo Puyo 20th anniversary came out in 2011 to celebrate the 20th anniversary of Puyo Puyo series. I'm impressed with this game, even if the graphic style is the cardboard style of Puyo Puyo Fever, and even if the Puyo drop speed is still slow, it's one of the best Puyo Puyo games I've ever played in my life. It's very fun. They made an effort with this game, unlike Puyo Puyo 7. It's the same concept as Puyo Puyo 15th anniversary, but it's 1000 times better. There is over 15 game modes in this game. 1. Puyo Puyo 1. 2. Puyo Puyo 2. 3. Puyo Puyo Fever mode. 4. The mission mode. 5. The Puyo Puyo Sun mode. Where this is my favorite mode. It's based on Puyo Puyo Sun. 6. Mega Puyo mode, based on Puyo Puyo 7. 7. Mini Puyo mode, based on Puyo Puyo 7. 8. Mini Digging Puyo, where you dig to get the treasure. 9. The Wind Puyo, where the wind will push you at random time to piss you off. 10. The Slot Puyo, where a random effect will occur every time we erase 30 Puyos. 11. The 4 next Puyo, where you will be able to see the 4 next group of Puyo in advance. 12. The Block Puyo, where you play with reduced space. 13. Active Puyo, my second favorite mode. In Active Puyo mode, the Puyo will never stop falling in this mode. 15. The Cross Spinner, where the field will change at certain moment. 15. The Quadruple Puyo, where only a group of 4 Puyo will drop. And 16. The Pair Match Puyo, where you play as a team by sharing the same life as your partner, and you can synchronize your chain with your partner if you and your partner is about to make a big chain. Puyo Puyo 20th anniversary possesses a money system to buy game mode, music, character voice, costumes and Puyo shape. To have a nostalgic feeling of the 20 years, many music came from older Puyo games. Like the intro music came from the intro music of Puyo Puyo 1 on Game Gear. And here's some more examples.
Thank you.
Another interesting thing about this game is that we can play two players with one PSP. To play online with the PSP, we have to use the PlayStation 3 ad hoc party where you connect the PSP to the PS3 and play online with your friend in ad hoc mode. By the way, here's another coincidence between my four favorite series: Sonic, Puyo Puyo, Mega Man, and Street Fighter. In 2011, two of Sega's franchises reached their 20th anniversary. Sonic and Puyo Puyo. And in 2011, two of Capcom franchise reached their 24th anniversary, Mega Man and Street Fighter, my four favorite game series. With my four favorite video game series, each game company have two of my favorite franchise sharing the same birthday. Coincidence or destiny? It must be the special effect of my mustache, linking my favorite game together. It's crazy. I'm really scared. Here's the game of Hyperdimension Neptunia. It came out for the PlayStation 3 in 2011. But look at the company that made this game. You can see Sega and Compile Heart. Around the year 2000, Compile that made Puyo Puyo for arcade was bankrupt and died. But a new company named Compile Heart appeared a few years ago and hired artist and employee that was part of the company Compile. In other words, Compile Heart is the reincarnation of Compile. This company makes RPG games like Agaris War. In Hyperdimension Neptunia, we make a lot of reference to old Sega games like Fantasy Zone, Altered Beast, Shinobi, Sonic, and a very small reference to Puyo Puyo. I noticed that. I have a feeling that one day Compile Heart will make a Puyo Puyo game with Sega. Let's hope that they will remove the cardboard box art style of Puyo Puyo Fever.
Here's the story. There is the human form of the Nintendo console. There is the human form of the Microsoft console, the Xbox. There is the human form of the Sega console. And there is the human form of the Sony console, the PlayStation. Those four consoles were at war. But the human form of the Nintendo console made a plan for that everyone gang up on the Sega console, and the Sega console was the first, and the human form of the Sega console was the first to die. And the human form of the Sega console, when she wake up, she had amnesia and she start her adventure. The main character is the human form of the Sega consoles.
Thank you.
This is the Puyo Puyo 20th anniversary t-shirt. With this, even a nice boy with a mustache like me will turn into someone arrogant.
What? You wanna fight? Come on, I can take you on. By the way, this is a PS Vita. I will make a review of this console in the future. The cameraman was jealous of me.
My PS Vita. You can't afford a PS Vita.
Anyway, Atsune Miku Project Diva F is a rhythm game made by Sega. It's a rhythm game where you control Vocaloids. A Vocaloid is an artificial product that uses human voices to sing songs. A computer with this function is called a speech synthesizer. Each Vocaloid possesses a unique human appearance, a unique personality, and a unique voice. A Vocaloid is a robot. A robot is an artificial agent. They are physical robots and non-physical robots that we call virtual robots or virtual pop stars that appears in the form of holograms. The most popular Vocaloids are Miku, Luca, and Lin and Len, the twins. In Asia, the popularity of these Vocaloids are comparable to Michael Jackson. The Vocaloids go to concert and appear in form of holograms. Sega, with the technology of video game, models these Vocaloids in 3D to prepare them for consoles. The Vocaloids often dress themselves as other Sega characters. I have the special edition of this game for the PS Vita and it comes with these items. Unfortunately, I lost one of the items that goes with a keychain, along with my Drago Center keychain that I was talking about. The PS Vita version of this game, the Vocaloid can appear in the physical world. This technology is amazing. Look at these costumes. Lin and Len can dress themselves as Puyo Puyo characters. And Lin tried to console Len with a Sega Dreamcast controller. They are twins. It's like the yin and yang. One of them is good and one of them is evil.
Yeti Sasquatch, have a letter for you.
He's inviting me to the north of Quebec for a final duel. He wants his revenge against everyone. He's starting with me. I must come alone, or else he will banish the word mustache from the English language by attacking the Supreme Court.
It's too bad Gil Gogo can't come. He was in the mood to kill someone today. It's his job to kill bad people. My car can bring you there in a few minutes.
It's minus 29 degrees outside.
Bigfoot Yeti Sasquatch, I'm here. Come and fight me.
You got? Where am I? We changed dimension. What are you doing? My head! The dimension is stretching! Change dimension again? I practice karate. Take this. My leg. You absorb over 600,000 kilo instant gain around the world to raise your power, including my game, Sakura's game, Ali's game, and Witch's game. This game represents the hope because it gave us instinct to find real friends. You are an S-class monster. Me, as a human, I'm a D-class. Even if you are stronger than me, even if you break my bone, I will continue to fight you. I do it for justice. Because of you, I will never play Killer Instinct with my friends again. Time to return to our dimension!
spirit of killer instinct used the combo breaker technique to cancel my death. Thank you! Spirit of killer instinct, raise my power!
Are you wondering how I managed to beat you? It's because I discovered your weakness. There are four types of people. Boys with a mustache, boys with no mustache, girls with sophisticated eyelashes, and girls with no more eyelashes. Girls with sophisticated eyelashes are the equivalent of boys with a mustache. Girls with sophisticated eyelashes are more beautiful than normal, and boys with a mustache use strategy to beat someone stronger. During our first fight, you were so strong that it was impossible to hurt you. But it was strange that Arlie's fire magic hurt you. And during our Puyo Puyo match, Drago Centers used fire to destroy your dimension. It was suspicious, so I used the Christmas present that we gave me. Lazy Cozy gave me a Christmas present that contained a PSN code that gave us a book of weakness of each element. With your appearance, it's obvious that your element is ice. My element is electricity because of the static electricity of my mustache. Electricity and ice have a neutral relationship, but this reveals that fire is the weakness of ice. Which confirms my suspicions. So I asked Drago Center to lend me the Ring of Fire to transform ice into fire and to break dimension, but I can only use each of these techniques once. I use strategy to beat you because you are way stronger than me. You are the strongest opponent I ever faced in my life. Now I must rest because the battle was very hard for me.
The person you saw on your dream will fight you one day, but don't worry about him for now. During your sleep, witch use a spell to heal your broken bones. Dokoloko and Goro took Bigfoot Yeti Sasquatch to the Supreme Court. He was found guilty for killing 600,000 killer instant game, and he is sentenced to prison for 15,000 years. I must admit, you use a good strategy to beat Big Foot Yeti Sasquatch. You can continue your movie in peace now. Killer Instinct can rest in peace.
Super Monkey Ball came out for the PS Vita in 2012. It's a puzzle game made by Sega where you control a field by tilting it to move the monkey to his destination without falling down. In some part of the game, you can see the statue of Sonic and the statue of Puyo Puyo. They are monkeying around. Even this game have element of Puyo Puyo game. This is the style of Sega, putting element of other Sega game in one of their game. In the game of Virtua Fighter 5 Final Showdown for PS3, a fighting game made by Sega, Sarah Bryan have the costume of Drago Center from Puyo Puyo. Drago Center is my favorite Puyo Puyo character, and Sarah Bryan is my second favorite Virtua Fighter character. Eileen possesses a costume of Asune Miku. My favorite Virtua Fighter character is Wolf, a Canadian with no mustache. And Akira have a bad costume of Shizu from Puyo Puyo. And Hellblaze have a costume of a superhero who look like Superman, who have nothing to do with Puyo Puyo.
Sonic and Sega All-Star Racing Transform came out in 2012 for the PlayStation 3. It's a racing game where your vehicle will transform depending on your environment. In this game, you can control Robotnik, who was available in the game of Robotnik Mean Bean. This game is exclusive to North and South America and Europe. So this game is not available in Asia. So we won't see a lot of Japanese characters like Sakura from Sakura War, Miku from Project Diva, and Drago Center from Puyo Puyo. And working from Valkyria Chronicles. But Sega is planning to add extra characters as DLC, and some Asian Sega characters might make it. If Drago Center from Puyo Puyo makes it, I will be so happy that I will go to all the HQ of Sega like Vancouver, Canada, Tokyo, Japan, and Moscow, Russia to hug and kiss all the Sega employees by telling them I love them, and I will ask all the male employees to be my best friend, and I will ask all the female employees to marry me until one says yes. In one of Sega's website, Sega Corporation asks gamers to vote for which Sega characters they want to see as a DLC, and this is the result. First place was Ryo Hazuki from Shenmue. Second place was Atsune Miku from Project Diva. Number 3 was Segata Shanshiro. Number 4 was Vector Man. Number 5, Toy Jam and Earl. Number 6, Bayonetta. And number 7, Vice Star.
This is Sonic Adventure 2 that came out in 2012 for the PlayStation 3, a long time ago. It's an HD version of a game that came out in 2001 for the Sega Dreamcast. Unique to this Sonic game, you can control Robotnik, the bad guy, in story mode. Robotnik was available in a Puyo game called Robotnik Mean Bean. It's a perfect excuse to show you this game. Robotnik wants to conquer the world. He is looking for 7 Chaos Emeralds to activate weapons in space that will give him military power over the planet. All the world leaders, like all the Prime Minister of the world, all the President of the world, all the King of the world, all the Emperor of the world, all the Pharaohs of the world, all the Dictator of the world, all the Prince of the world, all the Tribe King of the world, all the Pop of the world, all the God of the world, all the Ruler of the world, all the Baron of the world, all the Tyrant of the world, all the Lords of the world, all the Monarch Chef of the world, all the Shah of the world, all the Overlord of the world, all the Gerent of the world, all the Kaisers of the world, all the Potentate of the world, all the Princesses of the world, all the Sultan of the world, all the Mikado of the world, all the Magnate of the world, all the Democrat of the world, all the Republican of the world, all the General of the world, all the Mayor of the world, all the Principal of the world, all the Supervisor of the world, all the King's Private Council of the world, all the ministries of the world, all the senators of the world, all the House of Commons of the world, all the Shadow Cabinet of the world, all the Lieutenant Governors of the world, all the Conservative of the world, all the New Democratic of the world, all the Liberal of the world, all the Civil Service of the world, all the Tax Collectors of the world, all the Socialists of the world, all the Governors of the world, all the Administrators of the world, all the Autocrats of the world, all the Bloc Québécois of the world, all the Majesty of the world, and all the Judge of the world, all the world leaders, they will all start to obey Robotnik for the safety of the people. But Robotnik must take care of his enemies, Sonic, Knuckles and Tails, that will try to ruin his plan once again. In the future, a game called Sei Mado Monotagari will come to PS Vita. Sei Mado Monotagari is an RPG game based on the Mado Monotagari series. The RPG game with Puyo Puyo characters. During the time I made this video, the game is still in production, so I don't have enough information on it. Compile Heart is the one creating this game. It doesn't surprise me one bit, because I had a feeling that Compile Heart will one day do a Puyo Puyo related game. After all, some employees are members of the old Compile company. In the future, there is another Puyo Puyo game in production for 2013. It's called Puyo Puyo Quest. By the time I made this video,
I didn't have enough information about this game. So there's nothing I can say about it, except that it might come out for the arcade.
Well, it's the end of my movie. I worked really hard for this movie. It took me 48 hours to write the script of my movie. The script of my movie was 70 pages. It was very long to write it. It took me 24 hours to record all the voices of my characters and my voice. And it took me 240 hours to edit the movie. Now it's time to show you the credits. In the credits, I will show you the state of the characters, the speed, how one the character can fast, the power of the character is how much weight the character can lift over his or her head, and the IQ of the character to show you a good idea of how intelligent the character is. Bye everyone.